Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles X. And in this episode, we're going to be resuming the Pip Squeak mission. And while to do so, we need to head back onto the Manon ship. So let's do just that. And once we have arrived, Aganeba can be found here. And yes, hello, welcome. Did you bring a Noka Mira Stone, perhaps? In fact, I did. And if you need to find this item, it can be located here in the Whale's Nostril Cave. If you haven't been there before, you may not have one, but we do, and not very high quality, is it? Though I suppose it's good enough to use an Earth-made scale, maybe. Would you wait a moment? I'll refine repair materials, the likes of which you've only dreamed possible. Okay, and I gotta say, it's really hard to read this Races of Xeno's dialogue, because it always ends in a question, and done. I hope this serves our purpose. You were surprised the refine process was so quick, yes? Surprised by the total superiority of Manon technology? Question mark? Of course you are. Our science is the finest in all the universe. Not only will these refined materials repair your skill, they will also begin to bring its lacking defenses up a reasonable standard. So go take this back to the human who's waiting for it in the test hangar. We will do just that, and yeah, we have to walk all the way back to see Matthew again.
Cool.
Not cool, necessarily, since it's kind of annoying to keep fast traveling back, but hey, at least the option's there, and
you're back. Here comes Aganeba.
Yes, hello. I suspect that the materials are too much for human hands to manage, right? So I came by.
Yeah, just been. So where are all those materials you mean unrefined?
Apparently in my back pocket. Sort of. Don't think we should carry around sensitive materials like that. And
this is it? Wait, this is. That's not it. Hold on here. Oh, that's how it works. Dang, man. It's actually pretty clever. Sorry, kind of nerded out for a minute.
No, it's fine. And
still, these materials are impressive. And they're found into a process we never even thought about. I can see how they're in a sitch to work with. The results should be better than ever. Amazing stuff. Guess you Manon win this round.
yes, obviously. Perhaps you won't be so quick to doubt us in the future, okay? Manon technology is the finest in all the universe, you know.
So will you share this refinement process with us?
Yeah, that'd be pretty helpful if you did, Aganeba.
This technology would mean a drastic upstick in our efficiency. It also smells really cool, and
No. I'm sorry, but that's not possible, is it? No, I guess not. I mean, you know it.
Why the heck not?
Because teaching is such a pain in the... because that's proprietary Manon science. Yes, that's it. Oh, it's a trade secret. Come on, we really need this. And I can't giving it away, can I now? So sorry, but my decision is final.
Trying to run away with his stubby little legs, but
what the heck, man? Come on.
And that little fink. Here I swallow my pride and admit defeat. Now Z, respond. You blades are old hat at negotiating with other races, right?
I guess we're okay at it. And
I can try to persuade him to share that tick. Not for free, of course. I intend to pay them a fair price for the info. We've already come this far, so why not see through to the end, yeah?
That makes a good point. We've already been doing this quest for 2 episodes now. We might as well finish it up. And yes, Aganeba went back to his ship, so we have to go there again. Kind of annoying, but
my. More business with me, yes. Unfortunately, I have none with you. Okay, so sorry. Bye now, yes. A new deal. I take it by your choice of words, you're offering some info or object of value in return.
Yes, that is what a trade usually means, and you could pick any of these other options, but we're just going to try and trade with him, since I think they're good on credits and intelligence, so hey, maybe there's something you'd like,
and I'm interested in specialty products, yes, very interested. And what is it that you will be offering?
Well, there's a couple of things we could probably give you, but here's the thing, he really just wants some food.
Food? Yes, food? I will concede that in cuisine alone, Earth culture shows remarkable promise. But I see little reason to trade for it when I only need to walk into town and eat it right.
Yeah, that's definitely true.
However, if you insist, I'm willing to try a local delicacy of New LA.
So we got something that this Manon wants. Now it's time to get it. And I'm really tired of that Manon saying cool every time, but let's head to New LA and hit up my girl, Joe. How you doing, girl?
Welcome to the Sunshine Cafe.
What's that? eat an iconic new LA food, we've come to the right place because there's nothing more iconic than our famous Sunny Dog. It's a spicy hot dog with the works, guaranteed to stay molten lava hot from the first bite to the last. And talk about a bargain. This bad boy's only 600 credits. We have a little more than 600 credits, and order up! Yeah, don't worry, this baby will rock the pants off your Xeno buddy. Assuming he wears pants, and
that's a really funny line, but...
Yes, we need to gather three foods to finish this quest in a segment, and Primordia has updated. Neato! But that is not what we're here to do. Next, we need to come to Rose Moss. Hello, Pauline. Yeah, we're looking for some delicacy a man on might enjoy, and it's a calorie bomber, a juicy hamburger with all the trimmings, 700 credits. Hook me up with that, girl! And, yeah, knock the socks off your man on. I don't think they wear socks either, but how many calories are in the calorie bomber? Who on earth knows? But something tells me Aganeba won't care. But here's the last item we need to obtain, and seems to be a lot of man on hanging out here. And welcome to Army Pizza! Fortunately, I ran out of dough all day, so all I've got is frozen pies. With 10,000. Oh, frozen pizza for 1,000 credits? That's the Army Pizza guarantee. Alright, I'll try it, man, and I guarantee the pizza will blow you away! Alright, thank you, Powell, but now that we have all that food, it's time to give it to Aganeba. So once again, we have to go to the ship. A little bit of backtracking with this quest, but it's not too bad. And have you brought your American delicacy? Then maybe hand me your personal recommendation so I might sample it. So here's the thing, guys, just give him the pizza and... Oh, what is this? This is pizza. Chilled surface glisten with a frosty flavor. Does it not? Into my mouth with you. I try to not make the grossest eating sounds ever. And this is amazing, isn't it? I think my mouth might be alive for the very first time. The gritty texture, yes. The crunchy cheese, yes. The amusing pepperoni, yes. What's that? You meant to heat it first?
Yeah, dude, just ate a frozen pizza. I mean, some people like that,
and it doesn't matter. No, nothing matters except pizza, culinary crown jewel of all the cosmos. Even the Destroyer King, whose wrath rent planets in twain, would bow before the power of a pizza.
Give thanks to that I was born. Thank you, Mother. Thank you, Father.
Trade, yes. Yes. Our material refinement technique. Next to this pizza, offering the old thing seems to tantamount to insult, doesn't it?
The no that will not stop me from doing so. You have a deal, friend. If you accept it, of course. Silly technology tidbit. Quest Destroyer King. Seems a lot unfair, almost, doesn't it? Yeah, I mean, it's just a pizza, dude. You could have just went out and bought it yourself, but hey, we got what we needed, and he'll teach Matthew the refinement method. Why don't I simply perform it? Oh, no, he'll just do it from now on. Cool. That's a little bit better, because it's less work, and your understanding is most appreciated. You know, from this point on, Manon promised regular deliveries of the materials you seek.
I gotta say, reading this narrative sucks! It's just like, of,
and question mark after question mark, and this has been a most successful negotiation. How fortunate we are to witness both of our cultures taking a great step forward this day.
I look forward greatly to what else our partnership may yield. Okay, okay. And that is the Pip Squeak quest. Gotta say, kind of on the, you know, running around a lot, not super fun. The XP wasn't great either, but hey, you can't argue with those credits. And now that we've completed that, there's a couple of other things I want to knock out in this episode, such as, in the last video, we showed off that, yeah, we gave armor to Lynn to increase her potential stat. At the moment, she has 46. Not the highest, not the lowest, but this will increase the amount in which she can use to heal her allies with soul voices, and also the damage of TP skills. So let's show that off and take on a tyrant in Oblivia, because why the heck not? And back in Oblivia, we can encounter a tyrant on this piece of the segment map. Pretty much really close to the beginning of the area, and the sound sleeper is pretty accurate. But I already took the time to build up some TP off screen so we can show off exactly what the potential skill does. And we might as well try in, let's see, what order I want to do this in. This is going to aggro all the other bugs around here, but it shouldn't matter too much. In reality, I just kind of want to knock this thing down, and heck, we'll just do it right now. So, with potential, it increases the power of your soul voices. Like right there, we recover 200 HP. That's not bad at all. And all of our TP attacks are going to do a lot more damage. So it is completely possible to have a glass cannon type character that just has a ton of potential and then uses arts that
just, you know, scale off that potential. And you can basically craft a sort of last canon character. I'm not honestly a super big fan of it, though, but as you saw there, we completely destroyed that tyrant. And if this is your first time doing so, you would have explored a little bit more of Oblivia, but I kind of did this off-screen and didn't realize it was one of the tyrants I needed for the segment map, so that's why we didn't get any percent increase, but you might want to come over here and do that eventually. In reality, though, knocking down all the tyrants is not required. Eventually, we're going to get new technology. Let's show off thermal payload. Just so much damage. Oh my goodness, I love it. But yeah, as I was saying, it's probably not the best idea to go hunting tyrants right now, but we're going to do this in this episode because, honestly, I haven't been doing it enough because we will get better technology later on in the game, and we're going to be able to do a lot more damage. So taking on the tyrants will be much, much faster. It is very easy. Just wait until later on in the game to get better equipment if you want to 100% the entire map. But yeah, there goes the sleeper. Now that we've taken care of that, though, is another aspect of this game I want to show off, and we didn't do it in the last episode because we were too busy killing random indigens that weren't really too powerful, and that is Overdrive. So for this, we're going to put Elma in front, and I actually need to edit some of her arts because now that she is around level 20, she has a couple of new moves. So let's check those out, and one in particular I really, really want to show off. So let's see, what do we want to ditch here? Side Slash is okay, but honestly, Blood Sacrifice, a little bit on the stronger side. Upper Hand, Shadowrunner, we can ditch for a little while. Shadowrunner is fantastic for exploring the area, but not... Did I really... Today is not my day for menu navigation, but... Let's rearrange some of our arts real quick. Essentially, what Blood Sacrifice does, it halves your HP, and then you gain 1,000 TP. It is really, really strong in conjunction with Soul Sacrifice. Essentially, get her HP really, really low with Blood Sacrifice, then use Electric Surge, and it's pretty much double dipping. Yeah, I'm a real big fan of it. And let's see, is there... The problem with Elma is there's so many good skills and TP arts, it's hard to get a perfect build for her. But yes, we're gonna be using these two skills a lot from now on because, well, they're... And yeah, I do not want to waste that much PP, but... Rank 3 should do. So let's, yet again, take on another tyrant, this time in Noctilum, and show off the Overdrive ability, because I know you guys want to see it in action. And okay, back in Noctilum, there is Oscar the Summer Squall, but before we battle him, let's use some Blood Sacrifice and build up some TP. Now, when you have 3k tension points, you can get rid of all of them to activate Overdrive, and luckily for us, the Full Metal Jaguar is very easy to get TP on, so let's initiate this battle. And I know this is a level 11 tyrant and all, but still, it is very powerful, so we need to be careful, and as soon as we get 3k TP, we get to show off the Overdrive, and let's do it! Not really Trans Am, but it's pretty accurate. But in Overdrive, you unlock the ability to get the Titulary cooldown for your arts, which makes them become extremely powerful. There are tons of combos you can do within this form, and yes, you can do a ton of damage. And luckily for us, since we're playing as Elma, getting TP is not a problem at all. Blood Sacrifice, we can literally do it again. And this isn't going to be the best demonstration of how to do insane amounts of damage and take zero damage when in Overdrive, but yeah, with Blood Sacrifice and Electric Surge, right now we're doing pretty good damage, and I know I'm probably doing this completely wrong, and there's going to be a guy that's like, no, you need to do it in this order, but this is a rough idea of why Overdrive is so broken. And once we get a move called Ghost Walker, which I guess we could technically use Elma's Ghost Factory, which is the funniest name for a move ever, we are going to do some serious damage. And I love this part of the song. We rarely get to hear this part of the tyrant battle theme because, well, we don't really fight a lot of tyrants, but when we do hear it, it is awesome. And oh, that attack does a little bit. Let's hurry up and knock down the Summer Squall, and I can definitely heal you up, but I'm gonna not because it's time for Overdrive again. Yeah, I'm activating 3 Overdrives inside of the same battle. You do need to be a bit careful though, because when you are using Overdrive and if you're using the Blood Sacrifice technique, yeah, you're gonna run out of HP really quickly, which is why you probably want someone to tank. And yeah, 6k damage, just like that. It's pretty nice, and later on, we're just going to be abusing Overdrive, and it's going to be awesome, especially when we get a late game and we get some skill augments that are going to help us do a lot of damage. And really, that's where... whatever. We probably should move on to a different appendage, but, well, it doesn't really matter. This is no level 11 Tyrant, and I know my speed on this was not fantastic, but hey, what are you going to do? I just really wanted to show off Overdrive a bit here. You can do some insane damage given the right setup, and once we show it on my main character, oh my goodness, guys. Bosses are going to be a thing of the past. Let's see if we can't show off another Titititary combo on Electric Surge. I don't think it does a lot of damage to this specific Tyrant, though, so it probably would have been a better idea to show up us on literally anything else, but yeah, this thing shouldn't be around for much longer. I just decided, hey, I have the basic mission for this Tyrant, and we haven't shown off this gameplay segment, so might as well knock out two birds with one stone, or two giant elk lizard things. Yeah, but now that we've taken care of that, there's actually another thing I want to do in this episode, and it involves an affinity mission. And well, this affinity mission doesn't really involve Elma or Lynn. In fact, I'm going to use it as an opportunity to build up some affinity with some of our male party members. So let's put our control back to our main character and head back to New Los Angeles so we can build some affinity with Gwyn. Not just Gwyn, though. In reality, we're going to be bringing Elle along, too, since, well, we might as well try and get affinity with both of them, since Elma and Lynn are doing pretty good. But yes, this affinity mission is pretty easy to find. It's right near here, and as long as you're at level 12 or higher, you should be able to accept it. So let's begin a new rival.
Hello? Yes, could you not... You there, the one about to take that mission, I'm speaking to you. You know, non-diplomatic people like you are a real problem. You're why we still have war. Or maybe you're just hearing impaired. I don't know. Whatever. I'm continuing. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. The mission you were about to take. I analyzed it based on criteria ranging from Pathfinder experience, build, intelligence. Yes, well, in aggregate, the data clearly indicates that the more qualified candidate is me, Hector Birtwistle. I invite you to set pride aside and allow me to handle this, for humanity's sake. Quite simple, really, because I'm more skilled than you. I can offer a total guarantee of success, whereas you, well, cannot. Here, this other mission should be right up your alley. I believe that picking two samples of Zezian Fleawort should be well within your abilities. Is something amiss? You seem dissatisfied. Tragic. You now insist on comparing yourself to me. The solution is clear. We'll both complete the three missions I just accepted. Only one of us can finish first. This will provide the loser, by which I mean you, ample chance to understand the gap separating us. Whenever you eventually complete those missions, come find me here. I'll be waiting.
So, this guy wants us to do a couple of tasks. Well, does he know I already have one of these completed? Yeah, if you've been following this guide, you already have the probe that he wanted us to install completely finished. So, part of this affinity mission is already completed, and as long as you have a little bit of Meranium lying around, you can knock out the next part.
Are you Blade who agreed to accept my request?
I presently require 300 units of Meranium. Man, I got more than that! Come on, give me a hard request, and I'll give it to the arm manufacturers ASAP. Thanks for aiding the city development. Man, no problem, don't even mention it. So that was the second part of this first part of the affinity mission. However, the third section may take you a while. We need to get enough revenue in one cycle from Frontier Nav. And the issue is, It's not hard to gather some material, but it's gonna take a while, so yeah, I'll be right back. And okay, we finished that, and yeah, I get a little bit more revenue than how much HB wanted, but after you wait a while and get the revenue and all the resources you need, well, return to HB, who's here in the administrative district.
Finally back, are you? I fully understand that you aren't finished yet, but something's taken precedence. However, I'll be good enough to offer an extension on our little contest in the meantime. Yes, I realize you... What? Done? As in completed? Well, naturally, I completed them as well, so I suppose it's not impossible? Still, this is something of a shock. It seems my initial assessment of you may have been lacking. Perhaps it would be best to brief you on this mission. One of our citizens was cornered by hostile indigens in a cavern and attacked. He is a scientist of most considerable repute. New LA cannot afford to lose his talents. Do you understand? Even a moment's delay on our part could risk the future of human technology. Do you feel capable of assisting me in this operation? I'm certain someone of your proficiency will only hold me back a little. Excellent. Let us set out immediately. I'm taking a risk on you, you know. I hope you will not disappoint.
So, to knock out the remaining part of this mission, we're going to be bringing along HB, and yeah, he's another Shield Trooper Plus. Not the most exciting thing ever, but we have to bring him along. And now that we got him, let's head to the Rusted Lake, back in Noctilum. Again. Yeah. It seems like we would keep coming to the same areas in this episode. It's kind of weird, but this is where we want to be. There's some soldiers... and they're not doing so hot. Hey guys, how's it going?
You're the reinforcements?
Correct. You're from the escort detail, yes? Can you give me a status report?
Dead. They're all dead. Those things swarmed and the scientist survived. He hid in a vehicle further ahead.
We can't waste any more time. Let's clear out the creatures ahead, then evacuate our scientist. I'm glad to see you're a rational thinker. The two of us will work well together. Now follow me. We'll move quickly, but cautiously.
Gotta say, it's a little bit cruel to leave this guy hanging, even though, yeah, we need to get to the scientist, but... Hey, you're just a robot, you'll be alright, we'll fix you up eventually, even though it doesn't really work like that. And I really needed to be up there, god dang it. Alright, now that we've picked the correct path, and I really should be using the follow ball when doing these affinity missions, this is the last indigen we need to defeat, and unfortunately, he's surrounded by other enemies, but once we knock out this guy, the path to the scientist should be easy to find, and I gotta say, guys, HB is not very exciting in battle. In fact, I don't think any of the DLC characters are honestly too great. Disagree with me if you like, but in this version of Xenoblade Chronicles, the North American release, we get all of the DLC characters without having to pay any money. I gotta say, that's really cool of Nintendo of America that they do that. When they really didn't have to, we probably would have bought them anyways, but... they're not really too amazing. They do give you basically 8 free affinity missions, which in itself is really cool. And I don't... how did HB die? I guess he was not focusing, but it doesn't matter. We have literally zero risk at dying here. It may take me a little bit while because L and HB are on the brink of death. What the heck, guys? Are these things really giving you that much trouble? But back to what I was saying, though. I really hope we can survive this. They're not really too amazing. I will be covering their first part of their affinity mission, but I may be saving the other half of their story for the post-game. The reason is just there's so many party members in this game, guys. I want to give them all equal screen time, but that's gonna be a little bit on the difficult side. But yeah, if you're a high enough level, this shouldn't be too tough for you. Honestly, just focus on the first Indigen's tail, or if you are a low level, just try and bait out these enemies and knock them out before you take on the main Indigen, and then everything should go your way. It's not too tough of a mission. And me and Gwyn, we're doing all right. I assume L and HB's, like, defenses just were not up to snuff. Like, they were using, just aether damage, and they had a really low aether damage. Not too sure, really. But yeah, our main character is kind of kicking butt. And once we change our job class and max out the Galactic Knight, oh boy, you guys are gonna see some crazy damage. But yes, just a little bit more damage, and they should all be destroyed. And that is pretty much it for this Affinity mission. It's a little bit on the brief side if you have the Meranium and Revenue around. But yes, this is Solan. How you doing, buddy? Hope you're okay.
Is it safe?
Indeed. And all thanks to the blades you're always sneering at.
HB, is that you? You came running to save me? Boy, I sure did pick the right college buddy. Hoo boy!
That has nothing to do with this. I came here because you have certain skills. Skills that NLA requires. Your death would be problematic. There was nothing personal about it.
Same old HB. Still, you saved my life and I won't forget it. And I'll never make another crack about Blade either. Scientist's honor.
See that you don't. As I say, researchers are vital to our success on Mira. But without us, you'd all be dead. And you performed well. Truth be told, I might have struggled on my own. A tad. If I can return the favor at some point, I would be open to assisting you. I see now that you are worthy of the honor of being my partner. The future Blade Commander just showered you with praise, and that's your reaction. Not to be overcome with joy. In any case, you now have the opportunity to work at my side again in the future. Let's spur each other on as rivals and friends and so forth.
And okay, mission accomplished. And I gotta say, HB is a interesting character that after completing this we now have access to, and he has his own signature arts that I'm kind of not a fan of. In my opinion, I did play with him a little bit off screen, just seems like a weaker L. But after completing this Affinity mission, we got one Heart of Affinity with Gwyn, which is, well, what we needed. And now that we have that, we don't have to worry about late game since we already have one heart with him. But that is not all I wanted to do in this episode. But unfortunately, that is all I can do in this episode because getting that Meranium took me forever. Not Meranium, but the Revenue took me forever. But in the next episode of Let's Play Xenoblade Chronicles X, we're going to be exploring more of Noctilum. And come to think of it, we're going to be getting rid of HB. So thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.